Welcome to this dual Python setup video for Windows. Let's start by downloading a 64-bit Python 3.6 installer for Windows. I pre-downloaded the installer and I will leave the links in the description below. During installation, you would like to add Python 3.6 to your path. Then you will leave everything here in the optional features. And on the advanced options, you will tick the lower three boxes before hitting install. Once you hit install, you will be asked for admin privileges to install Python 3.6. So while we're installing Python 3.6, I'll browse to the Python website and look for the 2.7 installer as well. We'll find that under downloads and all releases. We'll scroll down, look for Python 2.7, click, and again, we'll be scrolling down and looking for a 64-bit installer. So just as before, I pre-downloaded this, so you don't have to look at me downloading files. Right. Let's head back and also check the two other files that we are required to download. So we need to get a build tool for Visual Studio, and this is required for you to compile the Python packages that we'll be using later on in the upcoming video for the virtual environments. So this is the Visual Studio build tools, and we will also need that for Python 2.7. So I'll be downloading these, and I'll also install them at the end of this video, so we'll get to that later. For now, we'll just close the browser windows, and we'll be staring at the screen while we are installing Python 2.6. Speed up the process, so we don't have to wait for all of this. However, I've started the command prompt, and this is in preparation to show that Python has indeed been installed. However, we ticked the add to path while installing, and since the command line was open before the installation finished, we won't be able to find Python yet. So close, then open our command line, and now we will have Python available from the command line. And this is Python 3.6. We can also start Python 3.6 using py-3, and this is using the Py launcher available for Windows. We don't have access to py-2 yet, because we haven't installed Python 2.7 yet. Okay, so let's do that. This is fairly straightforward, not nearly as many options as with 3.6. However, we can add Python to the path again here. If you do that, then when you execute Python from your command line, it will be starting Python 2.7 rather than 3.6 as happened before. So let me just show you that again. So I didn't add Python 2.7 to my path, meaning that when I now start Python from command line, it will default to 3.6. If I exit and use py-2, then we will be invoking the Py launcher, which will read that parameter -2 and start Python 2.7 instead. Same way you can start Python 3 by using py-3. So there you go, that's your Python dual environment. And now we will be installing the Visual Studio build tools. Again, this is required for you to compile Python packages later on, and we will be doing that in the upcoming video as well. So here you'll be ticking the Visual C++ build tools that will give you an entire Windows 10 SDK. It will take 4.5 gigs of your precious hard drive. And if you know of any way to avoid this, then please leave that as feedback in the comments below. There used to be an offline installer available that would take up around 100 megabytes, and you'll see that this is still available for Python 2.7. Okay, so let's install that. This is the build tools for 2.7. Again, there's nothing really fancy here, just accept install. I'll speed up the video again, and you will soon have your dual Python installation finished.